Hey guys, today I'm going to share with you the makeup that I am currently using and everything that is in my everyday makeup bag. For me, makeup is definitely my hobby. It's something that I really enjoy. I like collecting it. It's just my thing. It's what I like. Some people like jewelry, some people are really into shoes. My thing is makeup. So I think that I have a pretty large collection for the average person, and I really don't like to waste my products, so I like to keep a few different things and kind of condense my collection down into one bag that I like to kind of trade out products every month so that I'm rotating things out and really using the things that I have. So I like to keep a good collection of things. In this makeup bag here, I got this from Sephora. I looked online, they don't have this print anymore, but they do have this similar style with a different print. I keep a good stash of things in this bag that I pull through and work through throughout the month, and then at the end of the month, I kind of take things out and swap them for other things in my collection. So I am gonna go ahead and share with you everything that I have in here right now. I don't have just one of everything. I do have like three different blushes, a few different bronzers, because I don't do the same makeup look every single day and I like to have a variety. So yeah, we're gonna go ahead and get started. What I like about this makeup bag is it's got two different compartments. So it's got a smaller compartment at the top, which I keep like my palettes and stuff in, and then the bottom I keep just everything else. So we're gonna start in the largest area first. I'll try and go in order of how I would apply things to my face, I guess. So we're gonna start with primer first. And the primer that I'm currently using is the Too Faced Primed and Poreless. I've talked about this a lot of times. I really love it. This is like my third bottle, but I think I may have used like the very last bit of it today. So I need to go out and purchase another one of these, but I'm kind of thinking of maybe trying something else too, because I've been using this one like crazy. So yeah, there's that. And then I have a few different foundations. I actually have three different ones in here, I think, because depending on where I'm going, what I'm doing, I kind of like to wear different ones. So the first one that's in here is the Loreal Pro Glow. I just recently mentioned this in my favorites video. This is a really nice, lightweight, medium coverage foundation, and I'm in the shade 203 Nude Beige. I also have the It Cosmetics CC Plus Cream. I mentioned this in my makeup must-haves for new moms. This is absolutely amazing. It's one of my favorite products. I wear this almost every single day. This one's in the shade Light, by the way. I forgot to mention that. And then another, the last foundation that I have is the Becca Aqua Luminous Perfecting Foundation. Mine is in the shade Fair. And sometimes I wear it by itself, but I kind of like to mix this in with other foundations. Like, I mix in both the Pro Glow and the It Cosmetics CC Cream because it just adds, doesn't really add any color, it just adds like a nice luminosity. So if like mixing a shimmering skin perfector liquid from Becca is into your foundation just too much for you, this one adds just the perfect amount of glow and luminosity to your foundation to make it look really healthy and glowy. And then we are gonna move on to concealers, and I have two concealers. I'm finishing up the MAC Pro Longwear Concealer right now. This is in the shade NC15, and I'm almost done with this, but I really love this concealer. And then the other concealer that I'm also rotating between is the Urban Decay Naked Skin. This one's in the shade Fair Neutral. Both of these concealers are very similar to each other, extremely similar. This, the Naked Skin, is a little bit more of a drier formula, I would say, but it's more brightening, the shade is anyway. So I like both of them. I'm rotating between them. I am using more of the MAC right now just because I'm trying to finish up this bottle. This next product, I've pretty much wore it out on my channel talking about it, and it's the Chanel Bronze Universal Cream Bronzer. It's amazing. I love wearing this every single day. I wear it underneath a powder bronzer. It is just a really amazing product, perfect for adding a healthy, warm glow to the face. I just absolutely love it so much, and I finally hit pan on this thing. And it smells really good too, but I will definitely be repurchasing this whenever I've used it up because it's just an absolute must-have for me. To set my under-eye concealer, I have been using the Laura Mercier Translucent Loose Setting Powder. I was setting everywhere that I put concealer with this, but I feel like sometimes that's a bit heavy, even though this is a translucent powder. So I've just been setting my under eyes and my lids when I prime them with this. I just feel like it's the perfect under eye setting powder. And then to set the rest of my face, I am finishing up the Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush Flawless Finish Powder, and mine's in the shade 2 medium. I am just working around the rim here. Honestly, when my products get really low like this, I tend to just toss them because, one, I don't want to mess up my brushes trying to scrape the rest of the product, and two, it just gets really difficult. There's hardly anything left in here, so I'm going to need a new translucent kind of face powder soon, so leave your favorite translucent compact face powder in the comments down below because I'd love to know. I keep two powder bronzers in here. This first one is the Too Faced Sweethearts bronzer in the shade Sweet Tea. There's two different shades in here, but I always mix them together. And this is the one that I'm wearing today. This one has a bit of a shine to it, it's not a shimmer, but it's definitely like a sheen, but it looks very natural on the face. And then for the matte bronzer, I use, this is the Becca Shadow and Light Bronze Contour Perfector. No one ever talks about this, and this is my second compact of this. This is one of my favorite bronzers. As you can tell, I have hit major pan on it, and it's just very natural. It's beautiful. It's light when you swatch it, it doesn't swatch the best, but when you apply it to your face with a brush, it's beautiful. So no one ever talks about this, and this is one of Becca's best products, I think, for sure. I have three blushes in here, and this first one is from NARS, and it's in the shade Luster. It's a beautiful, sheeny, glowy apricot color. It's beautiful. It looks really healthy on the face. I hauled this summer, and I used it constantly, but I love to keep it in my everyday makeup bag because it's a really pretty everyday blush for me. And then the next two are from Tarte. This first one I'm wearing today, and I've been wearing it nonstop, and it's exposed. It is a really pretty, I'm running out of fingers here. It is a really pretty kind of dusty blush, a dusty rose blush. It's all matte. It's beautiful. It goes with absolutely anything, and I'm just obsessed with it. And then the next one is Tarte's Blush in Captivating, and this one is just a really gorgeous coral, kind of like a peachy coral, I guess. It's very, very bright, so I have to use a light hand, but it's beautiful. It's perfect on the natural days just to add a really pretty, healthy flush to your cheeks. Love it. I do have two setting sprays in here, but they're both very different. The first is the Urban Decay All Nighter Makeup Setting Spray. This just helps my makeup to last all day. And then the next is the MAC Prep and Prime Fix Plus. This does not help to extend the wear of my makeup, but if my makeup's looking a little bit heavy or powdery, I will spray this over top, and it kind of just helps to blend everything together and look less powdery or cakey, if you get what I'm saying, because Lord knows I can get a little heavy-handed from time to time. So that is everything in like this big main compartment. Now we're gonna work on this little pouch up here, and I'm gonna try and go through this quick because there's nothing really in here to swatch. I have two different brow pencils. One is the NYX Micro Brow, and I get this one in the shade Ash Brown. This is the best brow product from the drugstore. And then I also have the Anastasia Brow Definer, and this one's in the shade Medium Brown. I choose either one of these based on how fresh my brow wax is. So if my brows are super clean, I will use the Brow Definer because it's got a bigger applicator. And if my brows are kind of wiry and all over the place, I will use the Micro Brow because I can be a lot more precise with it. I have two brow gels, and I'm finishing up the Gimme Brow from Benefit. This one's in the shade Medium Deep. It's their original packaging, and this one's almost gone. I like to use this one too if I'm not going to fill in my brows with a pencil and I just want to add a little bit of color to them. I'll use this. And then I'm also using the Anastasia Clear Brow Gel. Before, when I first started my channel, I didn't use this. I thought it was kind of a waste, but now that I've been growing my collection, trying a lot of different things, it is a really good brow gel, and it holds my brows in place a lot better than the Gimme Brow does. The mascaras that I'm using, I have the Supersizer from CoverGirl. This one I like to wear whenever I am applying false lashes because it just kind of lightly colors my lashes. This isn't the best mascara, I don't think, but it gets the job done when I'm applying falsies. And then I have a deluxe size, again, of the roller lash. I get deluxe sizes of these all the time. Sephora has these as 100 point perks a lot, and this is one of my favorite mascaras. It's really good at volumizing and lengthening. I have two eyeliners. I have a pencil, and this one is the Urban Decay, I think it's like their 24/7 pencil, and it's in the shade 0. It's just a very basic black. And then I have the Maybelline Eye Studio Gel Liner in Black is Black for when I want to use a gel liner. I also have a paint pot in here, Max Painterly, but I really haven't been using it that much. I got this to prime my eyelids whenever I was getting my lash extensions put on, but since I don't have lash extensions anymore, I'm pretty lazy about using this extra step and I just use concealer. I have an eyelash curler in here. This one is just a basic one from the drugstore. And then I like to keep lip balm in here because my lips are very, very dry. So I've got a bottle of Carmex, which this does wonders for chapped lips. And then this one I put on when I'm doing my makeup just to kind of hydrate my lips before I apply any lipstick. And this is the Sugar Advanced Therapy Lip Treatment. And this was like a 100 point perk from Sephora, I believe. Okay, so that is everything in the two inner compartments. I'm gonna move on now to the top layer of my makeup bag, which holds all of my palettes. So I've got a contour palette, my highlighting palette, and then a few different eyeshadow palettes that I've been loving lately. The first palette that I have in here is the Anastasia Glow Kit. Mine is in the Sun Dipped. And I've been using these nonstop. I really use these two mostly. The bronzed is just too dark for me to use as a highlight, but it's pretty as like a bronzer topper, a blush topper, or a eyeshadow. And then Tourmaline looks really dark, but it's actually really pretty if I want more of like a pinky lavender highlight. So these highlighters are amazing, and I think that this is just a really great value for the price and how much you get in it. And then the contour palette that I've been using lately is also from Anastasia, and it's her light to medium contour kit. This is the powder contour kit, and I really like this. I really like the contour colors in here for my fair skin right now. These two are a little bit warm for contour, but I do use this if I'm wearing like more of a warmer bronzer. Just depends on which bronzer I'm wearing. Like if I wear the Shadow and Light Bronze Contour Perfector from Becca as a bronzer, I'll use this shade right here as a contour, but today I'm wearing this one just because the Too Faced Sweet Tea bronzer is a better tone with this one. And then this one I really don't use. It's a little bit too orange for me, but really what's great about these contour palettes is that you can totally use these as eyeshadows too. I currently am not using any of the top highlight shades as setting powders because I really, really like the Laura Mercier Translucent Setting Powder. My favorite matte eyeshadow palette right now is the Visage Neutral Matte Palette. I just mentioned this in my current favorites. I'm obsessed with this. I use it every single day. I have this as my transition shade, this one in the crease, and then I have other palettes that I'm using to kind of add color and depth everywhere, but this is like the perfect everyday matte palette. You can use this palette with literally any other eyeshadow palette to create whatever look you want. The shadows in here are just amazing and they blend out so incredibly well. They're so pigmented, so smooth. I love this palette so much. And then I have three smaller palettes that I kind of work off of the Visart palette with. The first one I also mentioned in my current favorites. This is the Bare Minerals Duo in the Top Shelf. And then I also have two palettes from Charlotte Tilbury, and neither one of these palettes have any matte shades, so that's why I like to use them with the Visart palette. They're just complement it really well. This first one I'm obsessed with. It's the Golden Goddess palette. And then this other one is really great for fall, and it's the Dolce Vita palette. Love these. If you want to see a video more in depth on the Charlotte Tilbury eyeshadow palettes that I have, just let me know in the comments down below, and I will be happy to do that for you. That is everything that I keep in my everyday makeup bag. It is a lot, but I literally work off of everything in here for the entire month. And then at the end of the month, I kind of go through what's in here and swap them out for other things in my makeup collection so that I make sure that I get really good use out of and I'm using up a lot of my products. If you want to see like the makeup that I'm currently using like every month or two, like when I switch products out, I would be happy to do that for you guys. Just give this video a thumbs up or leave a comment down below and letting me know you'd like to see that. I didn't mention any lip products in this video because I swap out lip products on the daily, but I will mention the lip combo that I have on right now. The lip liner that I have is the Charlotte Tilbury Lip Cheat in the shade Pillow Talk, and the lipstick that I have on top of it is the Hot Lips Lips. It's one of the Hot Lips lipsticks from Charlotte Tilbury as well, and it's in the shade Kim KW. So that is my lip combo right now, but I don't keep any lip products in my makeup bag because I swap those out on the daily. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. And I will see you guys again very soon.